So if you're in there we go. So if you are interested in checking out previous classes, all of them are available on the UKC's YouTube page, as well as on the UKC website, the UKC.org. So you can check out all of the past classes and you can watch them and hang out. And Cali has done a number of classes with us and they are always incredible. I actually love going back and watching them just for myself so that I can work on my own little skills and adding new little skills to my repertoire. A real quick announcement. We are it's in celebration of our 10th anniversary. We are actually throw having a benefit in just a few weeks, Monday, May 8th. If any of you are in the New York City area and interested in a night of ukulele wonderfulness and Broadway, if you are Broadway fans, we are teaming up with UKC Broadway. Laura Benanti is our headliner, along with a number of other incredible Broadway artists who will be performing. We'll have a couple UKC kids there. We'll have a number of wonderful auctions. So if you're in the New York area and you want to attend, please feel free to get a ticket. If you're not in the New York area but you still want to watch, you can actually purchase a live stream ticket so you can watch the whole thing live. And of course, also participate in the auction. There are some incredible ukuleles, beautiful, beautiful custom-made ukes, as well as some Broadway signed custom painted ukuleles, some sports things. Some you can tell the sports things. You can tell I'm a musician and not an athlete, and as well as some other Broadway paraphernalia. So, if you're interested, make sure you check on our social media, the UKC.org/Broadway. I am going to stop talking and hand it over.
I just muted you. I'm sorry. Can you unmute yourself, Stephanie? We were getting some other sounds, so I muted everybody. Sorry.
No, I was literally just saying I'm going to stop talking now and hand it over to you to take it away and teach us some awesome new skills.
I love what you say, the wonderfulness of ukulele, the wonderfulness of ukulele. Wow. Thank you so much. And we'll see you at the end of the show. Thank you. End of the show, the end of the class. So I am slowly letting more folks in. The chat is open. So if you have questions or comments, feel free to type in what you're feeling at the moment. And I welcome all of you. I'm Callie Rose, and I teach the CC Strummers and others in Los Angeles. Oops, let's see. Letting some more folks in, multitasking here. I just am very grateful that you're joining us today. We're going to be talking about finger picking on the ukulele. And, you know, let's just start off by rubbing our hands a little bit and see if you can make some heat here. These are the only hands we've got. We want to take care of them so they take care of us. And we can keep playing for as long as we want. So I'm making some heat. And now it's as if I'm washing my hands in the sink, but no water, no soap. But the motions are very similar. And I'm just giving my hands a nice massage. And if you have some extra sore spots, give them a little bit more attention. I have arthritis in my thumb. I'm a professional musician since in my 20s, and my main instrument is piano, and I've played so many rotten pianos over the years on my gigs that I really have done some damage. But who cares? That's why you buy this stuff on Amazon, and it allows me to play relatively pain-free, but you know, I'm very conscious of taking care of my body parts so they don't get any worse. So, you know, since you know, let me show you one more exercise. I'm going to clasp my fingers together like so, and then hang on, let me do this, and then roll out towards you. So you roll out towards me, and just push that edge because we're using our bodies, our whole bodies, to make music. I think it's so easy to forget. We think the ukulele is the instrument, but we are the instrument. Ukulele is not going to make any sound until somebody like you holds it and strums it. So, now, because this is finger picking, let's just try an experiment, okay? I'm just going to hold my hands out like this, like a little dog begging. You just let my wrist just sort of hang like that and close my eyes, because I want to just feel the sensation of a relaxed hands. Now, to contrast that, let's clench, I mean, really hard. You can see that I'm shaking, I'm clenching really hard, and then release. Do you recognize the difference? Let's clench again, one more time. And then release. I don't know about you, but when I'm learning something new, I clench up and I really, really tighten up. When I'm teaching my beginner's classes and I walk over to somebody and I just want to readjust their fingers, and it feels like I'm pulling off something with a vice grip, you know? Here, let me let Cindy in. Hang on. And it's just that we're stressful times, folks, and it's reflected in our bodies. And if we're really tense when we're finger picking, it's not a delightful experience. So don't hesitate to do this a little bit and rub your hands a little bit. Remind yourselves, yeah, it's just chill. It's a ukulele. It's just chill, right? So we're going to try one more experiment. Now, let me go to my side here. I'm going to take with my right hand. We can just do this with our right hand. I'm just flipping up like this. Because, you know, when, let's let Lisa in, when I hear the word finger pick, the word pick implies to me that I'm doing this, right? You know? And that's not quite it. Now, watch what I'm going to do with my fingers. I'm doing like a little hinge movement here. You see that? Now, let's do this. All right. And then let's do this. I don't know that much about crabs that run across the sand. Just what I've seen in National Geographic Channel. But don't they kind of run like this? Na-na-na-na-na-na-na. So all the action is their claws, their feet. Do they have feet? You know, na 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 na. But their bodies are still. Now I want you to see how with my right hand, it's the fingers that are doing all the movement. My hand is staying still. So now, let's just bring our hand in to the sound hole, over the sound hole, which is where we finger pick, like so. And just notice on your own body, where are you connecting with your arm to your ukulele? Depends on your anatomy, how big or how small your ukulele is, but you got to be connecting somewhere. We don't have a right hand arm that's free floating, please. So for me, you can see I'm connecting right here. Where are you connecting? So we've got to do that. And I want you to see the arch in my wrist. My wrist is not flat. When I'm strumming, it's a bit flatter. But finger picking, I want to come down as vertically as I can. So watch, I'm just holding the ukulele like this. Fingers are coming down like this, a little arch, like so, and I'm making a connection right here. Okay, so now let's go. Let's let go. Not going to worry about doing anything with our left hand right now. And let's just strum. Now, where are you strumming? Am I strumming over the sound hole? No, no, no. With the ukulele, the sweet spot to strum is over the fretboard, just to the left of your sound hole. We don't strum over the sound hole like a guitar player would. We're not playing guitar, okay? And I'm just using my fingernail, my index finger, to strum down. Okay, now let's get into a finger picking position. You see how I have to move my arm? When I was strumming, by the way, my connection with the ukulele was right here, my upper arm. Now, when we just move our hands over the sound hole, different connection here, and make sure you've got that arch in your wrist. You have to determine how much of an arch you need for those fingers to come down as vertically as possible. And I guess you figured out, I'm going to assume that some of you have never practiced finger picking before. So we really are starting at the very, very, very beginning so that you have a good foundation, and you don't hurt yourself, and you work efficiently as you're making a music. So now I'm in my finger picking position, and I'm going to explain what's going on here. I played guitar for decades and on gigs. So I've brought a lot of that guitar sensibility over to the ukulele. So this is my style of finger picking. There's lots of ways to do it. Mine isn't right and others are wrong. I think the best thing is to watch many, many people, many teachers, and then create your own way, find your own way. So this has worked for me. When it comes to finger picking and also doing chord melody as well. So here I am in my position, and I'm going to show you what's going on, and then we're going to walk through it one string at a time. Each finger, except for the baby. Baby's taking a rest. Baby can go to sleep. Each finger has its respective string that it's going to pluck. So now, and I'm going to assume you all know what the strings are called, because we're going to be using that way of identifying where we're at. We have the G, C, E, A. George Clooney eats arugula. My favorite, go crazy every afternoon, which would be about now. Here in California. So the thumb takes care of the G string. I have a low G. This is going to work better with one of the songs we're going to be doing. But if you have a high G, don't sweat it. It's fine. So now, I think in my mind, finger picking, and my fingers begin automatically take their position. The thumb is going to obviously pull down, pluck down. So let's just try that, just isolating the thumb, and just at the count of four, one, two, three, four, one, two, and what did I do? I closed my eyes. What a precious thing. We are making beautiful sounds. So let's just enjoy that. And you can see that if you push in a little harder, it's a little louder. And then let's see if we can play it really soft. Adding dynamics, like playing soft and loud and everything in between, makes you an artist. Allows you to interpret a song in your unique way. So the thumb is going down. The other fingers are tucked under the strings and they're coming up. You know, north, south, east, west, west, east. this will never cease to confuse me, like which way is up and which way is down with the ukulele, which way is right, which way is left. So I usually go nose to floor, floor to nose. So we're going nose to floor. Now let's pluck the C string. So the index finger is taking care of that, plucking up. Now, I did not do that. The finger is like a hinge. It's the finger. Do you see? Watch my index. Let me let Lisa in. Here we go. Watch my index. I'm exaggerating just a little bit, but do you see this? Do you see the rest of my hand moving? As if you're plucking? No. You want to make sure that this part of your hand is very soft and very still. It really helps to practice in front of a mirror so you can be your own teacher. So now let's go back and forth between the G string and the C string. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, are you pressing too hard? If you are, shake it out. Take a breath. Let's do it again. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's add the E string. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we're doing G string, C, E, C. We're making a little circle, which is one of countless ways of finger picking. There's so many patterns. We will not live long enough to be able to play them all. Now, let's go from our nose to the floor playing all four strings. You ready? 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now go back to the thumb. So it'll be nose to floor. I hope you're tapping your foot because we are drummers. It's one of the fun things about the ukulele. I've got a drum machine, which I turn on with my foot. We're going to play this in rhythm. I can't begin to tell you guys how important it is that whatever you are playing, if you're even just doing an exercise or whatever, play it in tempo so we can reinforce our connection with our internal sense of rhythm. So here we go. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Try closing your eyes and just let your fingers do this. Finger picking is so soothing. If I'm watching the news, I make sure I have a ukulele in my lap so I can make it through. All right. Now, you know, this is recorded. This class is going to be recorded, but we're going to move ahead. And what we're going to do, you may not quite grab this, but if you keep noodling, you will. We're going to take this same pattern from our nose to the floor, and what we're going to do is double time it. What we're doing here is we're plucking on the beat. We're just doing finger picking in 4/4 time today. So this is on the beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, what if we want to add a little bit more energy to our finger picking pattern? Well, here's what we can do. We would play a sound on what we would call the eighth notes. Now, how does that translate to the ukulele and to counting? Instead of counting 1, 2, 3, 4, we would count 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, and we would do 8 things in a measure rather than 4. Here's 4. 1, two, three, four. So what does that look like, playing the ukulele? It means that we're going from our nose to the floor twice in a measure. Let me show you, and then we're going to do it together. Here it is on the quarter notes. One, two, three, four. Eighth notes. One and two and three and four and one. And three, four. One and two and three and four. And let's try it with the drum. You ready? So every other measure we're going to change back and forth because we can't. Why not have different finger picking patterns in a song, for heaven's sakes? Keeps it interesting, and you get to arrange a song differently each time you play it. So here we go. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One and two and three and four and one, two, three, four. One and two and three and four and one, two, four, one, and two, and three, and four. So now we have two finger picking patterns, and we're going to do them with a song now by ear. So I sent you a couple songs, Blue Eyes Crying in the Rain and Aloha Oi, but this one is by ear. In my classes, we always do a song by ear so we can experience the other branch of music, which is intuitive, which is using the intelligence of our bodies to inform us what harmony works and what harmony doesn't work. So we're going to do Hush Little Baby, just the first stanza. We're in the key of F. It has only two chords. So if you're playing an F chord and suddenly it doesn't feel right, hooray! Listen to your body. Play a C7. So we're going to just strum through this song first. Just eight measures. So let's try it. Two, three, four, F. Hush, little baby. C7. Don't say a word. Papa's gonna buy you, F, a mockingbird. And if that mockingbird don't sing C7, Papa's gonna buy you, F, a diamond ring. Now I'm strumming. I got over the sweet spot here. Let's do our finger picking position. All right. We're just gonna do on the quarter notes. I congratulate all of you for attempting to multitask. I can't tell you how challenging and how satisfying it is to be able to play an instrument and sing at the same time, but it does not happen overnight. So start off by just humming or grunting, and let me sing for you. A one, two, three. For a hush, little baby, C7, don't say a word. Papa's gonna buy you an F, a mockingbird. And if that mockingbird don't sing, Papa's gonna buy you a diamond ring. Now let's double time it. You ready? Two, three, four, a hush, little baby, don't say a word. Papa's gonna buy you a mockingbird. And if that mockingbird don't sing, Papa's gonna buy you a diamond. So, you know, my classes are very interactive and collaborative. Do you have questions? How is this going for you? All you need to do, I can't unmute you. You have to unmute yourself and tell us what's going on. This is usually when nobody talks to me. And I go,
yeah. Can you do the double time again?
Yes. And okay. And what's your name, darling?
Annie.
The double time, it's the same motif. It's the same sequence. It's just that we're doing it two times in a measure, which means we have to play it faster. Instead of one, two, three, four, it's one and two and three and four. And this might be a good practice, and I can't stand that word practice, but this might be a good thing to work on this. One, two, three, four, now double time. And on the beat, quarter notes, eighth notes, one and two and three and four and one, two, three, four, one and two and three and four and, because you know, with music, especially in ukulele, I find that the transition between techniques is where I have to put a little extra attention, because you know, if you want to play a song and do a lot of different things with the ukulele during that song, you're going to have to transition between different techniques, and let's just sort of smooth them out. I want to show you one more finger picking pattern. This is a bit more challenging, and you know, I'm just going to hold this up. This is my worksheet. What is it? We've got three quarter time down here, so don't worry about that. I've done a two-part video, and you can check it out on my website, which is calirose.com, and it works with this worksheet as well. And this is just to get you started, get you into the tent, so a whole world of options opens up to you. We're going to look at this one here. And you know, so I took a little highlighter and I turned it into a geometric form. One of the players in my ukulele group was saying that she did this and it helped her picture a little bit better what this particular finger picking pattern is all about. So look at your worksheet. It's this one. I'm calling it Let's Get Fancier. You call it whatever you want. The thing about this one that's a little different is we are plucking two strings at the same time. And I use this finger picking pattern so much. Let's walk through it. It looks like this. And I'm going to make an F chord. Isn't that pretty? We're still working with just making sounds on the quarter beat. We're doing four things in one measure. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. But on that third beat, one, two, I'm playing two strings. Now, in our finger picking position, that means we're playing the A string and the E string. What are the dedicated fingers in this position that take care of those strings? It's the ring finger and the middle finger. So let's just try this. I'm making an F. Just pluck those two strings. Just get the feel of doing two strings. And let's stop. And then let's do it again. And close your eyes. It's kind of a quantum leap when you're used to, in finger picking, just picking one string at a time. But of course you can pick more than one string at a time. So now let's put it together. First beat, remember we have one, two, three, four beats. Pluck the G string, C string, now the E and the A. And then the C string again. The C string gets to party. We play the C string twice. Wow. So it looks like this. Two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three. Let's try it with the drum. Two, three, four, F. Try closing your eyes. It's okay to make mistakes, for heaven's sakes. We might as well feel into this opportunity to make beautiful music here. All right. Let's try this with Hush, Little Baby. Here we go. Hush, little baby, C7, don't say a word. Papa's gonna buy you a mockingbird. And if that mockingbird don't sing, Papa's gonna buy you a diamond ring. Now let's try nose to floor. Hush, little baby, don't say a word. Double time. Papa's gonna buy you a mockingbird. Now two strings. And if that mockingbird don't sing, Papa's gonna buy you a diamond ring. So what did we do or attempt to do? We took three different finger picking patterns and we threw it up in the air. And we mixed and matched in 8 measures. And you get to mix and match any way that you want. What is calling you? How did you do with that one? That's a little bit more complex, that finger picking pattern. How did that go for you guys? Again, nobody talks to me.
Good morning.
Okay. This is Lisa. She's chiming in from Melbourne. What time is it in Melbourne?
It is 9:30 a.m. Wednesday.
It's Wednesday. So we know that the world made it to tomorrow because Lisa is proof. Okay. How's it gone for you, Lisa?
Oh, the finger picking pattern was great until we had to change chords.
I'm sure that you are not the only one. We all go through this. So my suggestion would be slow it down. And that is not a sign of failure or anything else. That is practicing like a pro. That's practicing smart. Because if you slow it down enough, you're going to be able to make that transition. Don't even try to sing yet. That'll be the icing on the cake, okay? Because honestly, you guys, if you do this over and over, repetition, it becomes automatic. It's that muscle memory, and you don't have to think about it. And that's when we can add the other layers of singing and other fancy stuff. Lisa, thank you. Anybody else?
When we changed chords, everything was beautiful until I have to use my left hand.
Oh, that sounds familiar too. Okay.
I just freeze up with the chords.
You freeze up. And you're doing okay with the right hand if you don't use your...
Oh, yeah. And then when you all of a sudden will say F, I'll go, oh my God.
So when I say F, if you were strumming, would you be able to play that F chord yet? If you were strumming.
Yeah, I could. Mm-hmm.
You know what, it just feels to me that you just need to keep doing it. And to slow it down.
That's what I was just going to say.
Yeah.
I normally don't finger pick. I strum almost strictly. And doing this just now, Cali, you have great leadership, and I'm working my way into it very quickly. And that's what I realized when I went to change to the C7, I realized, oh, I better slow down. I got to give myself the moment to be able to get there.
Exactly. And thank you, Michael. Michael's one of our bass players in our group. I use a drum machine. And I just slowed it down to 60 beats per minute. Now, those among us who take our pulse, 60 beats is about a resting pulse. I really want us to tie in what these tempos feel like in our bodies. And so if we were going to do, Hush, little baby, don't say a word. Papa's gonna buy you a mockingbird. Start with the simplest finger picking pattern, which would be nose to floor, and then let the others come when they come. Now, you know what, darlings? If that's too fast, slow it down. 50 beats per minute. Hush, little baby. C7, don't say a word. Papa's gonna buy you a mockingbird. And if that's too fast, slow it down. I highly recommend you buy a drum app and work with a drum machine type of thing. I like Music Beats Plus. It's a plus sign, and it's available especially, I think, only for iPhones. But if you can't do that, find a metronome setting on your computer and work with it. This was 50 beats per minute. I can't begin to tell you how much that's going to help you, because you'll internalize it and then begin to feel it yourself. You know, thank you for your question. Slow down. Now we're going to take these finger picking patterns, excuse me, and we're going to try them on Blue Eyes Crying in the Rain. Happy birthday to Willie Nelson. He turns 90 this Saturday. Wow. And boy, he's quite a finger picker. You can learn a lot watching him. And if you watch his hands, darling, you know, his hand is still. His fingers are doing this. So, you know, we can learn a lot from our guitar playing brethren. So I'm going to keep this relatively slow. Rock beat. We're just going to do verse one in the intro of this song. We're in a different key. We're in a different neighborhood. And I really impress upon the players in my groups how important it is to know what neighborhood you're in, because then we know what landmark to look for. The landmarks would be certain chords. And if we're in the key of G, we're going to look for a G, some kind of D, a D7, and a C chord. And that's the three famous chords in the key of G. You've heard the saying, for all you need is three chords and the truth for a great country song. And that's what we're going to do. And just a quick aside, our group has worked with the Ukulele Kids Club for years. I think we've donated over $10,000 over the years to keep UCLA Mattel Children's Hospital stocked with ukuleles. And before the pandemic, we were doing rounds with their music therapist every 2 months. And we would go from room to room and sing for the kids and give ukuleles away. And I would say to, there are about five or six of us at one time, and I'd say, okay, we're doing Old MacDonald Had a Farm. The key is C, it's a 1-4-5. And that was all the instruction they got, because they would say, we're in the key of C, I know the neighborhood, it's going to be a C, F, and G7. This is vital. You're musicians. This is the language of music. So we're the key of G. Just on the verse, we're just going to have a G and a D, and maybe we'll do the bridge, and we'll go to a G7 and a C. So just so we know how this thing goes, let's just strum it a little. The intro. 1, 2, 3, 4. In the twilight glow, I see her. Blue eyes crying in the rain. So you have a little idea how this thing goes. but we're going to finger pick it. I suggest just start with the nose to the floor. If you're comfy with that, try double timing it. If you're comfy with that, try our finger picking pattern where we're plucking two strings at the same time. Mix and match. Let's try it. We're going, I'm going to make it a little faster. Sorry. But it's still slow, 60 beats per minute. All right. A one, two, a three, a four, a. In the twilight glow, I see her. See if you can double time it. Just give it a try. When we kissed goodbye and parted, I knew we'd never meet again. Okay, we're gonna do the bridge. Deep breath. Love, love is like a dying ember. I think I'm gonna cry. Only memories remain. See if you can try the one with the two string thing. Here it is. Through the ages, I remember blue eyes crying there. How did that go for you? Well, we took those three patterns, if you could, if you're ready, and molded them into this arrangement. Were you able to do some of that? Come on, talk
do
to
you
me.
Have a I know this is going to sound weird, but I don't know how to read these kinds of chord charts. I'm used to looking at music.
Oh, you're used to looking at sheet music.
Yeah, so I don't really understand what those four slashes are. Is that just the beats?
Good guess, darling.
Because it didn't seem like it really synced up for me.
Yeah. Believe me, it synced up. I lose sleep in the middle of the night if I don't sync something.
Because I've seen these without them too, and I just say forget it.
Yeah, you know, I've just learned. I've been doing arrangements for quite a while now, and I've learned to put the slashes in. But that's a really good observation. I'm going to hold this up, and just look here. We have a G chord, and we have four slashes. That indicates where the measure starts and the all-important downbeat, which is the first beat in a measure. It grounds us into the movement of the song and keeps us in the pocket. What is the pocket? One, two, three, four. So when you're reading sheet music, the measures have vertical lines, right? So they delineate one measure from another. We don't have this. You're not going to find this in ukulele charts. You're going to find something that's more like this. And oftentimes, they don't even put in the measures. So you don't have quite as much information. So this is a measure. And then a set of four slashes without a letter means that we're still playing the G chord. But here's the downbeat on that word. Here's the downbeat on that. I can't read a backwards on that one. And then here's another measure, and here's another measure. So one thing that might help you, it's Magda, right? Is yeah. Look at the word. So in verse one, it's in the twilight glow I see her. What I did is I strummed down on the downbeat. So yeah, it's kind of, you know, and there doesn't seem to be a whole lot of uniformity in ukulele charts. So it's like we have to be a little nimble with that. Very few ukulele players I've encountered read sheet music.
That's all I play. I mean, that's all I play. Yeah. The people I play with,
well, you get
actually
to,
reading notes.
You get to work with civilians. Woohoo! So maybe that helps a little bit, but yeah. Very good observation. Who else would like to share about how this is going? Well, I wanted to show you something just with a verse. How we can use finger picking and strumming together and using that finger picking pattern as a fill. Now, what does that mean? That means when there is a little space in the song, when we're not singing, but there's still music, and we can add a little fancy thing. So just looking at the first line, I took a highlighter, and what I did was I highlighted that set of four slashes, that measure, that comes just before the D chord. Can you all see that? I don't want to screen share it. I just want to kind of hold it up there for you. I want you to watch what I'm doing. Maybe you can play along with me. I'm going to strum that first line. I'm just going to do down on the beat. But when it comes to that measure that happens just before the D chord, I am going to finger pick as a fill because I'm not singing, and I have more bandwidth to concentrate on something that's fancy or fancier on the ukulele. So watch this. I'm going to turn on the drum. 3, 4. In the twilight glow, I see her. Now watch this. Eyes crying in the rain. We're going to do it again. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I went to the second line. We had two opportunities to add a fill. This is jumping up in levels of playing and singing at the same time. But let's just try it together. Just the first line, skip the intro, through maybe the first third part, the first third of the second line after the word rain. So let's just try this together. 2, 3, 4. In the twilight glow, I see her. Fill. 1, 2, 3, 4, D, blue eyes crying in the rain. Get ready for another fill. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you get to be an arranger on the spot. I aspire to fill my goodie bag with so many musical ideas that I can pull them out and play them and not do a song the same way twice. I am coming from the perspective of a lifelong performer. I've done thousands and thousands of shows, and I want to keep it interesting for my audience, and I want to keep it interesting for me. I don't want to get stuck doing the same thing. So that's an idea of how we can use finger picking as a fill. And you might be going, well, who's Phil? It's F-I-L-L. It's not Phil. It's not Phil who's gone out to dinner tonight. So let's look at our last song, because I wanted to show you something else we can do with finger picking. It is Aloha Oi. And we're running a little bit low in time. So what we're going to do is just look at that intro, because we're going to create a solo over that intro using finger picking and finger picking. We are going to intimate, just grab a little bit of what the melody line is. I'm going to show you. So we're just going to grab a little bit of that using our finger picking technique. Why we can do that, especially in the beginning of this, it's eight measures, is because a lot of the melody is baked right into the notes of the chord. So let's make an F, okay? I'm going to show you what we're going to do. I'm counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Not kidding. We're plucking from the nose to the floor, the G string, the C string, the E string. If you have a high, if you have reentrant tuning, it's going to sound different, but it's still going to be pretty. So let's try this slowly together. 2, 3, 4, G string 2, C string 2 beats, E string 2 beats, strum for 2 beats. Again, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Now doesn't that sound like Aloha A? Now, this sequence with our right hand, we're going to repeat it with a C chord. So find your C chord, and let's do the same thing. G string, C string, E string. And you can use your thumb to strum or your fingernails to strum. Let's do that again. 2, 3, 4. To do it with the drum. So let's start with the F chord again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Strum. C chord. Same thing with the right hand. Let's do it one more time. 2, 3, 4. F chord. C chord. Now for the rest of it, we're just going to finger pick. It's going to be a G7 chord. We're in the key of C, by the way. And you can do whatever finger picking pattern is calling you. So it'd be like for 2 measures. And then a C, and a C7, and that will lead right into the song. Let's put it together. You ready? Make your F chord. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, C chord. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now just a finger pick. And of course there's ways to fancy that up. We're just building the scaffolding around the song. One more time. good. You're combining finger picking and strumming. That's a pattern that we didn't talk about today, what the pattern I just did. But it is on this sheet. It is the Let's Get Fancy. This is straight from guitar. My guitar friends, we just love this one. So what you can do is go back and revisit these different options and add to your goodie bag. Any questions? Because we are rapidly running out of time. Let me know, how's it going? I'm going to put you on gallery so I can check you out.
This was very enjoyable for me.
Thank you.
A little bit more window for me to work on.
Oh, yay. Yeah, Michael, because Michael plays the bass and he plays the ukulele as well. Well, you know, with the Ukulele Kids Club, they invite the teachers to share a little song. So I've written a ton of songs. Usually I sing them, but I really enjoy writing instrumentals too. And this one is called Wintergreen, and I'm mostly finger picking. There is some strumming in there too, but I just want you to see the really cool stuff you can do with this technique.
See what woodshedding can do for you?
Da-da! So start finger picking. And Shizuko coming to us from Japan. We have a lot of folks here from my ukulele group, the CC Strummers. We're based in Culver City here in the middle of Los Angeles, but there are a lot of folks here who are joining us as well, and a special welcome to you. You know, check out my website. All our classes are online, so you can join us with the CC Strummers. We do all kinds of songs together. I have a beginner's class on Monday and an intermediate class on Thursdays and advanced class on Saturdays, there's going to be a one-day workshop this Saturday where we really fancy up a couple songs. So if you're interested, just log on to my website and check it out. And I thank you so much. I think our Stephanie is trying to feed her two little girls.
Allie, this is Jane. Do you have time for a question on this Aloha Away?
Oh, yeah, please.
Okay, so the pattern that we did on the intro, I'm looking at the chorus and it looks the chord patterns exactly the same, pretty much. Mm-hmm. So in trying to play, would you suggest doing the same thing about the, you know, strumming? I mean, I'm picking down and then the strum and then the finger picking like we did in the intro, or is there some kind of suggestion to do the chorus differently?
Do you sing?
Yes.
Because I'll tell you what my MO is when I'm singing, I want to keep the ukulele simple and unobtrusive, because the singer is the boss. The singer is the center of attention. But when you're not singing, that's when you can get fancier on your instrument.
Okay, so you would just suggest strumming on the one we're singing.
I would, if you'd like, I guess we can. Why don't we go through the entire song until Stephanie comes on and turns us off here? Okay. So why don't we try that? And there are other places that we can stick that solo. You know, I'm just going to sort of try it with us. It's not written into the chart, but you see, you can take these charts and tweak them any way you want. Let's see. Let me see if I can go a little faster, too. Okay. So, and tell me your name again, darling.
It's Jane. I'm in your, oops.
Oh.
I never show my face, you know.
Yeah, that's well, I'm so, okay, now I know. Now I can put the face with the name. Hallelujah. All right, so let's try it. We're just going to go through all of Aloha Oi, but I am going to throw that solo in after chorus one and then proceed to chorus two, because after working so hard to learn the solo, I want to do it more than once. So here we go. Here's our beat. One, two, three, four. Let's try finger picking. One fond embrace before I now depart, until we meet again. Now go back up to the intro. Let's do that solo again. You ready? Fancy it up, believe me. Now, chorus two. Aloha, oi. Aloha, oi. Eke ono ona no. One fine to the end. Let's finger pick. One fond embrace. Oh, yeah, hey, until we meet again. We just did an arrangement, you guys. We tweaked it and made it our own. So thank you for your question. And bravo, bravo to all of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Callie.
Thank you, Debbie, great from class. Memphis. Thank you. Callie. Thank you, Lynn.
Terrific class, Cal. Thanks.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Callie.
Thanks for coming, you guys.
So much. Thanks for doing it.
My pleasure. So I'm going to turn the recorder off.